Zarya. The module that started it all. Launched in 1998, Zarya was the first component of the ISS placed in orbit. A Russian-built but U.S.-funded module, it provided the initial power, propulsion, and guidance for the station before later modules took over these roles. Today it is used primarily for internal storage and for fuel storage in its external tanks. Unity, the first American component. Unity was the crucial connecting node that joined the Russian and American segments of the station. Launched on the first ISS assembly flight of the space shuttle, it was attached to Zarya, officially beginning the international construction of the outpost. It is a six-way hub to which other modules, like the Destiny Lab, are attached. Zvezda, the functional core of the Russian orbital segment. Zvezda contains the primary living quarters for the Russian segment, including sleeping areas, a galley, and a toilet. It provides propulsion for orbit reboosts and supports station flight control, while the U.S. segment's control moment gyros handle most day-to-day attitude control. Destiny, the primary research facility of the United States segment. The Destiny module is a massive laboratory that houses dozens of science racks for a huge range of experiments, from biology and physics to materials science and Earth observation. It is the central hub for American and international science operations on the station. Quest, the primary door for spacewalks. The Quest airlock allows astronauts to exit the station for extravehicular activities. It is a joint airlock because it was designed to accommodate both the American EMU and the Russian Orlan spacesuits, giving the station a robust and redundant capability for conducting maintenance and upgrades on its exterior. Harmony, the main utility and connecting hub for the international laboratories. Harmony is the second of the station's three node modules and is attached to the front of the Destiny Lab. It is a critical junction, providing the attachment points for the European Columbus and the Japanese Kibo laboratories, as well as the primary docking port for commercial crew and cargo vehicles like the SpaceX Dragon. Columbus, the main contribution of the European Space Agency. Columbus is a sophisticated science laboratory that houses a wide variety of experiments in life sciences, fluid physics, and materials science. It also features four external platforms for mounting experiments and instruments directly into the vacuum of space. Kibo, the largest single module on the entire space station, this is Japan's primary contribution. Kibo is a complex of components, including a main pressurized laboratory, a storage module, a small robotic arm, and most uniquely, an external exposed facility, a porch-like platform with an airlock for conducting experiments directly in the space environment. Tranquility, the most advanced life support module on the station. Tranquility contains the station's primary systems for recycling wastewater into clean drinking water, generating breathable oxygen, and filtering carbon dioxide from the cabin air. It is a critical piece of technology that makes long-duration human habitation on the station possible. Cupola. Attached to the Tranquility node, the cupola is the station's window to the world. It is a seven-windowed, dome-shaped observatory that provides a breathtaking 360-degree panoramic view of the Earth and celestial objects. While it is used for observing and assisting with the station's robotic arm, its most famous role is providing a profound and inspiring view for the astronauts. Poisk and Rassvet. Poisk and Rassvet are two smaller Russian modules that serve multiple functions. Poisk provides a docking port and serves as an airlock for Orlan spacewalks, while Rassvet provides an additional docking port plus cargo storage and some payload operations. Leonardo, a retired Italian-built cargo carrier given a second life. Leonardo was one of three multi-purpose logistics modules that flew inside the space shuttle's cargo bay to deliver supplies. After its final flight, it was modified and permanently attached to the station, where it now serves as a large closet, providing much-needed permanent storage space for spare parts and supplies. Beam, an experimental inflatable habitat. Beam is a prototype module that was launched in a compressed state and then inflated to its full volume once attached to the station. Its purpose is to test the performance and durability of expandable structures in space, which could provide a lightweight way to build larger habitats for future missions to the Moon and Mars. Nauka, the largest and most powerful Russian module, launched after years of delays. Nauka is a massive new laboratory that dramatically expanded the research capabilities of the Russian segment. It provides its own crew quarters, a new toilet, and a dedicated airlock, as well as the European robotic arm, making it the most significant upgrade to the station in over a decade. Prichal, the newest Russian addition. Prichal is a spherical docking hub attached to the Nauka module. Its ball-shaped design features six different docking ports, creating a versatile new hub that allows multiple Soyuz, Progress, and future Russian spacecraft to dock to the station simultaneously, significantly enhancing the segment's traffic capacity. Bishop, the first permanent commercial addition to ISS infrastructure, designed to move larger payloads in and out and support satellite and payload deployments. Owned and operated by the company Nanorax, the Bishop airlock is a privately funded module designed specifically to deploy small satellites from the station. It is much larger than the Japanese airlock, allowing for a higher volume and cadence of commercial satellite deployments, representing a key step in the commercialization of low Earth orbit. Thanks for watching. Do you think future space stations will still use modular designs like the ISS, or move to something completely different? Let me know what you think in the comments. Please also remember to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video.